After seeing my recent video on my back scabbard, some people have said, you know, it looks secure, but you're not going to be able to do like flips and acrobatics with that thing. Well, challenge accepted. Shadowverse. Greetings, I'm Shad, and with the massive interest that has arisen from my recent video on my custom-made back scabbard, further questions have also come up. People wondering about different scenarios in which this back scabbard would be useful, and on top of that, I also have additional thoughts that I want to share about just back scabbard or back sword wearing stuff in general, and so that's what we're going to be covering in this video. Of course, the previous video is kind of required watching for this one, so I do really encourage you to go check it out, because as I mentioned in that video in regards to how easily you can put the sword away, I mentioned that it's all a matter of practice. The more practice you put into it, the easier it gets to putting it away one-handed. And as you can probably tell, I've had a bit more practice at it, and I think we can, there we go, it has to happen one time, but oh, look at that, it's back in. So I think we can pretty much say that when you have enough practice with this thing, yeah, I think putting it away is pretty darn easy. So, this thing works, people! An important thing to mention about designing one of these scabbards for yourself is the side opening is key. And if you're doing one for a larger sword, you're going to need a larger opening, because the sheathed portion of the sword that's actually being fully encased, can only and should only be as long as you're able to draw with your hand, okay? If this part is longer than what you can pull it out, it's not going to come out. So, of course, with this one, yeah, not a problem. One of the biggest questions that came up from my previous video about this back scabbard is that as soon as you put a backpack on, you're either gonna chop one of the arms off of your backpack or you're not gonna be able to draw the sword. There's a really, really easy solution for this, guys. And what it is, if you attach this sheath onto the side of the backpack. So your backpack would be on your back, funnily enough, and you just attach this scabbard to the side, because you get all the same advantages out of what you get from being on your back to be able to draw it from the side of a backpack, because you don't need to draw it full way out of a sheath if it was a regular sheath. You'll need to draw it, pull it out to the top of where this opening starts. And then you just pull up and then it'll go forward like that, and you're good to go. So this would absolutely work with backpacks. And yeah, adventurers, they would wear a lot of backpacks depending on what they're gonna do. If they know they're gonna go into a big fight or something like that, I'm sure they'll put their backpacks down on a donkey or something, or in a safe place, ready to do some fighting so they don't have to carry the backpack with them. The next question comes out of a very kind of clear connection that you can think of when talking about back scabbards, and that's with the Witcher, because he, of course, wears his swords on his back. And the question is, obviously, is what about two swords? Could you make something like this function with two swords? Oh yeah, absolutely. Instead of having two separate sheaths that are designed this way, you would make the second sheath as a permanent attachment to the first. And so the guiding portion, so remember how we have this guiding plate on the side? Well, you would simply make that out of the top part of the first sheath and offset the second sheath a little bit so there's a guiding portion for that second one to go in, and you're good to go. So this is what it would look like. First sheath, second sheath, and absolutely, you could have two swords on your back with this method or design. A lot of people brought up that I could add a kind of guiding lip on the top of the sheath, so on that, you know, this edge here, have that just come up a bit to make it easier for the sword to put away. And you're absolutely right, that would make it a lot easier to put the sword away if it was necessary, because remember, practice makes perfect. All right, so now to some of the possible problems that people have brought up in regards to a back scabbard. The first one being the speed in which you can draw the sword. Now this one, I'm a little divided on, because with your hands at normal rest, I think it is quicker to grab the sword on your side, but having said that, it's not that much quicker. You just go there, there, like, I'm not sure which one honestly would be quicker. Now, in regards to pulling the sword out, Well, I actually think this style of back scabbard would be quicker for a very significant reason. You don't need to pull it all the way out of the sheath to get it out. You only actually need to pull the sword up a third of the length of the blade before you can actually take it out of the sheath. But with one on the side, you have to draw it the full length of the blade to get it out. So let's look at that again. Full length of the blade. Now let's contrast that with the back scabbard, okay? You only need to pull it out a third of the way before it will actually come out of the scabbard and you're good to go. So when you want to speed draw it, you just grab and I think you're good to go. And then people were saying, it's funny, some people were intuitive enough to figure out you could easily attack someone with the same motion of drawing this from the back, but some people actually saying, no, you can't, and that was a weakness. With a side sword drawing, you know, scabbard, you can so pull it out, but it's actually a lot harder, especially with a longsword. A katana, the art of iajutsu, you know, the art of attacking someone while drawing it, harder with a longsword, because longsword blades, funnily, are longer and not, they don't have the curve. Katana's slight curve, but even that slight curve does assist in drawing it. And so attacking with the one motion, I'll get the real one, I'll get the real sheath. You have to remember, this is actually harder with a longsword. And so the different ways of doing it is to fully draw it out and then slash, okay? But you've got to draw it out even further. And you would have noticed then, I pulled it back with my hand. Let's be honest and keep it on my belt where it would be. Fully drawing it out, it's actually a little hard. Sometimes it gets stuck on the scabbard. Gosh, this one is even hard to pull in if I don't pull the scabbard away because of the length of the blade. But you can do it, I think, if you just do it like that. But I think you know where I'm going with this. So for a quick draw and a strike in the one motion, you just go up and down, all right? You absolutely can do a quick draw with this thing. And better yet, you can two hands and do a really big attack, something with a lot of power. That's kind of the problem with the side drawing, draw and attack. It's always gonna be one-handed. Very hard to do two-hand because usually you always need to hold the scabbard at the top with this hand. But even if not, you're just drawing it, it's kind of hard to get the two hands on it. An important point that I actually wanted to address, looking at back scabbard versus side scabbard and why perhaps side scabbards were far more prominent throughout all of history, was the fact of presentation, okay? Swords generally, not in all instances throughout history, but certainly a lot of them, especially if it was well made, swords were signs of wealth, prestige, and prominence, okay? And so presenting it where other people could see was a significant part about owning a sword. And it's hard to kind of see the sword when it's on your back, especially looking from front on. I mean, yeah, you can see it from behind, but what about the people you're facing, the people you're talking to, the people you're presenting yourself to? The sword is mostly hidden, and scabbards in the medieval period, they were rarely black, okay? They were canvases in which artworks were put on them. They had color, embroidery, carvings and designs. Scabbards could be absolutely stunning in the medieval period. And if you have a scabbard like that, you're not gonna, like, especially if you're not like going out into the world and you don't have the practical side of things to consider, the practical advantages that we did explore that you get out of a back scabbard. If you don't have those things, okay, you want to present your sword and scabbard to the world, and having it on your back is kind of hiding it. But on your side, okay, it's there, it's a bit more prominent. You can put it on the side, you can rest your hand on the pummel, you know, right there, like, look at my sword, people. You know which sword I'm talking about. Look at my sword, it's a fancy sword, and look how fancy it is, which means I'm rich. So yes, I have a sword and I'm rich. Look at it. And there's kind of like an imagery associated with each different method of carrying. On the back, it's more utilitarian, more functional, more, I just need it secured, I'm gonna be running around doing things, stuff like that. I need it comfortable, I'm walking over a long distance, on your back, secure, that's fine. But on the side, it's a bit presentable, it's a bit fancy and stuff like that because it's an adornment, a side ornament that you are presenting and showing off. So there are a number of reasons why swords would have been carried on the side more predominantly in history compared to on your back, and I think this is a significant one we should remember and consider. Oh, and I've actually named this design of back scabbard, and it is called the shabbard. The shabbard. Another point that a few of my viewers brought up was in relation to drawing the sword when people were adjacent to you or close by. And it was the fact that you actually don't need to pull it over your shoulder when drawing it. And they're absolutely right. If you wanted to pull the sword out from this back scabbard or shabbard safely, you just pull it out and gently go around like that. So there is a very safe way to draw this sword from the back. You don't actually have to pull it over your shoulder. Just go around, you know, pointing the sword down and then putting it back in the sheath like so. The next matter I want to address is that of horse riding. Now this was interesting because there was a couple of different comments in regards to this. Some people saying, well, obviously this would be much better for horse riding, and some people saying it would be worse. In my opinion, I actually think a back scabbard like this would be far more convenient on the back of the horse than not. Now, a couple of things. A sword hanging on your side, if it's generally on, you know, this side, you can use that to, you know, put your foot in the stirrup and go over, and so the actual sword wouldn't be getting in the way of mounting. But if you did it the opposite way with this foot, you'd need to kind of raise the sword as you hook this leg over. So that is a little inconvenient. The next issue is that of the jostling when the horse gets in full gallop. Now, if you've ever ridden on a horse, it can get really bumpy. Now, the sword, when it's hanging on your side, keyword there, hanging. When the horse gets into a full gallop, that thing is gonna be bouncing all around, and it actually might even bounce up to the point where it could slide out. But some people are saying, that's what's gonna happen with the sword on your back. If it's bouncing around, it could actually slip out. And just as I'm taking this off to demonstrate how secure this, you know, scabbard is for yourself, you know, riding a horse, just showing you me taking it off, which was something that heaps of people pointing out. If you needed to surrender your sword when going into an inn, you just take off the whole thing and hand it to them just like that. It's not that hard to get on and off. The next thing that I want to point out is how secure this really is in the scabbard, okay? I can hold it upside down, it's not falling out, all right? And so on the back of a horse with all the jostling around, this thing bumping up and down, like, can I even shake this? There we go, only a little bit did it pop up and down in that violent shaking like that, okay? It's not coming out. Look, I can even hold it by the sword and the scabbard isn't falling off, okay? When you have a scabbard that is perfectly made for the size of the sword, it's really snug in there, but that doesn't mean it's impossible to pull out. It needs the slightest tug and it comes out. Now, one of the issues that you might find when putting this or hold, you know, hanging this on your back is that the sword might start to slip down like so. And just get that there. And I did find that with my axe test videos and stuff like that. So I learned from my experience, and there was a very simple solution. And it was a matter of just looping this, you know, section of belt through my bottom one. I did that with the axe one, but it still slipped. And so it was a simple matter of looping it through twice, just like so. And then doing it up, does not slip down. Now it does pull up the belt, of course, so there are other ways to ensure that this doesn't slip down without, you know, your middle belt riding up. This works for me, okay, for my purposes. And honestly, it helps having a nice gut to hold the middle belt in place so it doesn't slide all the way up. So my keg is actually providing a functional, you know, purpose in this regard in holding the sword in place. I'll take it. Okay, back to horses. Now, unfortunately, I don't have a real horse to test this with, so we'll just have to try and simulate it, but I'll try and do it myself. I'm gonna jump up and down to get this sword out. It's not coming out. Ugh. You have to remember that this sword is strapped to the back, really secure, with one connection point up here and another connection point down there. So this thing is really secure. You can run full sprint with this thing, and if you're on a horse galloping at full speed, this thing would be much better in my opinion. Better than a side scabbard is what I'm talking about. What about the main question of this video? The one that's more in relation to Witcher kind of things, which is that a matter of acrobatics. Could you do flips and stuff with this sword on your back? Well, that is going to depend on which types of flips, because as soon as you have a type of motion where you're upside down and then you're kind of yanking or pulling yourself up, well, in that case, when you do that, the sword is going to come out, okay? It's very secure, as I mentioned before, it's being held in place, but like I said, a nice tug upwards will release the sword, and yes, I've proven this. Okay. So remember, this is not to say that the sword isn't secure in the sheath. We've already found out that, you know, this thing is very, very secure, but there's obviously a limit. Still, there's a simple fix to ensure that you could do all the acrobatics you want and not have this sword come out. And that's just having a tack or a type of leather strap just hooking over, I'll get close so you can see, hooking over the top of the cross guard. Now in the modern day, we have like little metal tacks or buttons or something that you just clip it in place. Yeah, in the medieval period, they usually would work with buckles and the like, and they could easily engineer some type of friction buckle where you just kind of pull that leather thing through and it'll hold it in place even when doing big acrobatic upside down things. And when you get in the motion where it's going to be a large push up, or, you know, pull up like that, it'll hold the sword in place. I didn't have time to engineer something like that, and so my temporary solution is just a little bit of string here looping over the crossguard, holding it in place. Okay, let's do this. I didn't lose my sword, but I lost my glasses. All right, ramping up now. We'll take away one hand and just do a one-handed cartwheel. So there we go, I think we have found our answer. With a slight and small little, you know, addition to the shabbard, you absolutely can do jumping around, flips even and stuff like that with a sword on your back. And I mean, it wasn't just to test if the sword would fall out in doing that, it was also to test how secure it would remain on your back when you're doing all those big high maneuvering things, how much it would flap around and things. And I think we have certainly established that this is really, really good and much more suited for jumping Witcher-like maneuvers than having a sword on your side. So thank you for watching. I hope you have enjoyed. And of course, I hope to see you again. So until that time, farewell.